U.S. Assistant Secretary for South and Central Asian Affairs Robert O'Blake spoke to Debrief via a Skype interview on the U.S.-led resolution on Sri Lanka at the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva. We began the interview by asking Mr. Blake what interest the United States had in Sri Lanka's human rights record at a time when it was grappling with its own economic problems and issues in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Well, our interest is in seeing progress towards reconciliation and accountability in Sri Lanka. The United States has been a long-standing friend of Sri Lanka, going back to the days of your independence, and we have worked very hard to support the process of development in your country. And we think that for your country to really be able to achieve its full promise, it's going to be very important to implement the recommendations of Sri Lanka's Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Commission and to take whatever steps are necessary to, again, ensure full reconciliation and accountability so that all of Sri Lanka can once again be unified and free and all of its citizens can live in dignity.
But the allegation from Sri Lanka is that it's being singled out. Similar actions have not been initiated relating to Kashmir or Burma, for example.
Well, let me just say that I think this is a very moderate and balanced resolution that the United States is advancing. It is not seeking to condemn the government of Sri Lanka, but rather to encourage progress on reconciliation and accountability. And for those of your viewers who may not be familiar with the resolution, it has three main operative parts to it. First, it calls on the government of Sri Lanka to implement the recommendations of the Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Commission. Secondly, it calls on the government of Sri Lanka to develop as soon as possible an action plan that comprehensively details how it will move ahead in this process and also to address these alleged violations of international humanitarian law and human rights law. And then third, it encourages the Office of the High Commission for Human Rights and other relevant UN bodies and people, special rapporteurs, to work with the government of Sri Lanka to help to implement and provide technical assistance for all of these matters that need to be done.
The Sri Lankan government has given an assurance that the LLRC recommendations will be carried out. Now, this is an assurance from a sovereign state. It seems that the U.S. is not accepting this assurance.
Well, you know, the government has made many assurances, and again, I think it's important now for there to be an action plan and for the government to take real action. And frankly, when I visited Colombo about 3 weeks ago or so, I came away with the sense that the government was still hesitating about whether to go ahead with an action plan on this. So I think, again, it's important to encourage the government to take action right now to develop an implementation plan. And as I've said in other interviews, the experience of many other countries that went through a similar kind of civil insurgency and then failed to take real concrete actions on reconciliation and accountability found that in many cases those civil insurgencies restarted because the levels of frustration were very high. And I think there's a similar risk here in Sri Lanka. And that's why we think it's so important now to proceed with this. And again, allow your country to fully realize the great promise that it has and to allow all of its citizens to live in peace and dignity.
Item 3 in the resolution gives some sort of access to the Office of the Commission of Human Rights to sort of intervene in Sri Lanka's internal affairs. Why was that necessary? Why was the third item necessary?
Well, Sri Lanka has always cooperated with the UN High Commission for Human Rights and other special rapporteurs in the past. Even when I was there from 2006 to 2009, there were many special rapporteurs from the UN who visited Sri Lanka and I think enjoyed quite a good deal of cooperation. So we think that this is something that Sri Lanka could benefit from, and I think they could provide a great deal of technical assistance on many of the issues that are within the Lessons Learned in Reconciliation Commission report. So again, we hope very much this could be a collaborative process.
Mr. Blake, there is some speculation that the resolution could lead to economic sanctions. Is that one of your objectives?
No, that's not one of the objectives. Again, this is a very moderate and balanced and simple resolution that, again, calls for the government to develop an action plan to implement its Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Commission report and to work cooperatively with the UN to accept technical assistance to help make that happen.
But will the United States allow the UN to investigate the conduct of your troops deployed elsewhere in the world?
Well, we hold our own troops to the very high standard we hold everyone else. And if there's ever any kind of an allegation against an American soldier of some sort, then those soldiers are going to be brought to justice. And, you know, the most recent example of that is the case of this soldier in Afghanistan, who's now in jail in a military prison, Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, for having, you know, allegedly killed 16 Afghan civilians. And there are many, many other examples like that, where our soldiers have been brought to justice for violations of international human rights law. And we're very proud of the record that we have and stand by that. And again, encourage all other governments to prosecute with equal vigor similar incidents of violations of either international humanitarian law or international human rights law.
The Free Mass Media Association protested Tuesday against the latest Channel 4 documentary and the U.S. advance resolution on Sri Lanka.
Yes, the media journalists of this country, and we have joined hands today to show our solidarity to the nation and also to protest the Geneva resolution, not only Geneva resolution, all international conspiracies. And we as Sri Lankans, Lady Sri Sinhalese, Tamils, Muslims, they are living together peacefully. There is a peaceful atmosphere prevailing in this country, especially after the 3 decades of war. The President Mahinda Rajapaksa has stopped this war, has brought this war to an end. After that, the Sinhalese, Tamils and Muslims are working and they are living together very peacefully. We are asking the international community not to disturb us. Don't interfere in our internal matters.
Api Amerikanu Janadhipathi Barack Obama ne kiyanne me thungini loke diyunina ratawallota atha daanda epa. Tamunnaasalaage aadarniya hastaya e atha apita denna. Deela me vaticcha ratawal nakittawanda. Ehema nathuwa me avurudu 30ak tissa ginigena dæwunu desha දැන් අපි යුද්ධය නිමා කරලා ඇමරිකාවටත් බැරි වුණු ලෝක ත්‍රස්තවාදය නිමා කරලා මිනිමරු LTT ප්‍රභා කරන ඝාතනය කළා LTT සමූල ඝාතනය කළා මේ ශීඝ්‍ර සංවර්ධනය කරා යන ගමනේදී අන්තර්ජාතික රටවල් විශේෂයෙන්ම අපිට උදව් කරන්න ඕනේ නමුත් කඩගාටු වල වගේ අපේ රටෙන් පැනලා ගිය හොර මාධ්‍ය වේදින් කියා ගන්නා මාධ්‍ය නඩයක් අද ඇමරිකාවට වෙලා ජිනීවා ස්විස්තර්ලන්තයට ගිහිල්ලා අපේ රට අපකීර්තියට පත්කරන මේ ගෙනියන හෙළුව බොරුව
Gotabaya Rajapaksa, Secretary, Ministry of Defense and Urban Development, told the South Asian Forum that the stability achieved in Sri Lanka after decades of conflict has opened up opportunities for investment and development.
Sri Lanka emerged from the shadow of a terrorist conflict that had lasted for nearly 30 years. Quite apart from the lives lost and the effect that this conflict had on our society, its impact on our economic development was tremendous. Now that we have achieved peace, a rapid economic growth is taking place after many years of stagnation. Because of the peace, stability and freedom now enjoyed throughout Sri Lanka, investors are very confident about this country's prospects. They are showing a keen interest to tap the great potential available in this country in many sectors. Tourists too are returning to Sri Lanka in large numbers. The government is confident that these are healthy signs of even greater things to come.
Sri Lankan academics signed an appeal to be sent to the UN Human Rights Council and its members to say that there is no basis for the free mass media. The Free Mass Media Association protested Tuesday against the latest Channel 4 documentary and the US advance resolution on Sri Lanka.
Yes, the media journalists of this country, and we have joined hands today to show our solidarity to the nation and also to protest the Geneva resolution, not only Geneva resolution, all international conspiracies. And we as Sri Lankans, Lady B, Sinhalese, Tamils, Muslims, they are living together peacefully. There is a peaceful atmosphere prevailing in this country, especially after the 3 decades of war. The President Mahinda Rajapaksa has stopped this war, has brought this war to an end. After that, the Sinhalese, Tamils and Muslims are working and they are living together very peacefully. We are asking the international community not to disturb us. Don't interfere in our internal matters.
අපි ඇමරිකානු ජනාධිපති බරක් ඔබාමාට කියන්නේ මේ තුන්වෙනි ලෝකයේ දියුණුවෙන රටවල් වලට අත දාන්න එපා. තමුන්නාස්සලාගේ ආදරණීය හස්තය ඒ අත අපිට දෙන්න. දීලා මේ වැටිච්ච රටවල් නැගිටවන්න. එහෙම නැතුව මේ අවුරුදු 30ක් තිස්සේ ගිනිගෙන දැවුණු දේශය දැන් අපි යුද්ධය නිමා කරලා ඇමරිකාවටත් බැරි වුණු ලෝක ත්‍රස්තවාදය නිමා කරලා මිනිමරු LTT ප්‍රභාකරන ඝාතනය කළා LTTE සමූල ඝාතනය කළා මේ ශීඝ්‍ර සංවර්ධනය කරා යන ගමනේදී අන්තර්ජාතික රටවල් විශේෂයෙන්ම අපිට උදව් කරන්න ඕනේ නමුත් කනගාටු වන වගේ අපේ රටෙන් පැනලා ගිය හොර මාධ්‍යවේදීන් කියා ගන්නා මාධ්‍ය නඩයක් අද ඇමරිකාවට වෙලා ජිනීවා ස්විස්තරලන්තයට ගිහිල්ලා අපේ රට අපකීර්තන පත්කරන මේ ගෙනියන හෙළුව බොරුව එලි දක්වන්න මං හිතන්නේ මේ මොහොත වන විට සංඝ වෙදගුරු ගොවි කම්කරු පංචමහා බලවේගයකට එකතුලා තියෙනවා.
Gotabaya Rajapaksa, Secretary, Minister of Defense and Urban Development, told the South Asian Forum that the stability achieved in Sri Lanka after decades of conflict has opened up opportunities for investment and development.
Sri Lanka emerged from the shadow of a terrorist conflict that had lasted for nearly 30 years. Quite apart from the lives lost and the effect that this conflict had on our society, its impact on our economic development was tremendous. Now that we have achieved peace, a rapid economic growth is taking place after many years of stagnation. Because of the peace, stability and freedom now enjoyed throughout Sri Lanka, investors are very confident about this country's prospects. They are showing a keen interest to tap the great potential available in this country in many sectors. Tourists too are returning to Sri Lanka in large numbers. The government is confident that these are healthy signs of even greater things to come.
Sri Lankan academics signed an appeal to be sent to the UN Human Rights Council and its members to say that there is no basis for foreign interference in Sri Lanka's internal affairs at a time when the government has considered recommendations of the LLRC report. The letter appeals to member states to preserve Sri Lanka as a unitary and sovereign state free of unfair and unjustifiable demands in the face of what they call attempts by certain forces through various forums such as the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva. You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.